हेलो गाइस, माय नेम इज़ दिनेश। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट फिल्टरिंग्स एंड मैट्रिक्स। सो एज आई हैव शोन हियर, वी हैव सम फिल्टरिंग मेथड्स इन रिप फॉर इनबाउंड इंटरफेस एंड आउटबाउंड इंटरफेस। सो वन ऑफ देम फर्स्ट इज ऑफसेट लिस्ट। ऑफसेट लिस्ट इज़ द मैकेनिज्म फॉर इंक्रीजिंग एंड डिक्रीजिंग इनकमिंग एंड आउटगोइंग मैट्रिक वैल्यू। So, as we know, RIP uses hop count, the metric value. So, whenever any metric value comes in update, you can modify that metric value, and the same update you can send it to your neighbor with updated metric value. Or any information coming from neighbor, we can modify the metric value and we can keep in our database. So, in both the direction we can change, we can increase or we can decrease metric value. So for that we can use offset list. Second filtering method is distribute list. Distribute list generally filters the route, which route we want to allow to be in our routing database and which route we don't want to advertise to our neighbor. So we can filter again when the update comes in and the update goes out of the interface. So per interface direction we can configure this distribute list. So distribute list uses two types of methods, ACL and a prefix list. These two filtering statements we can configure in router. So distribute list will take decision based on these two statements. So access list, as we know, is a kind of statement that defines whether the packet we want to allow or we want to deny. The prefix list is more advanced than access list. It has more flexibility, and here we can define the greater than and the less than prefix length. So here we can define the entire prefix length, the total number of bits coming in one particular address. And it can provide more flexibility because it has the prefix length facility. The ACL, again, if I talk about the ACL can filter based on a higher layer protocol, like you can filter TCP or UDP based on their port number, that we can't do in prefix list. But in prefix list, we can do based on the prefix length. So we can use both. So in practical, we will use and we'll talk about both. One is administrative distance, the calculation, what we see, the trustworthiness rating for routing protocols, which is 120 for RIP. So when the update comes in, you can modify the metric value. So if any update comes and you don't want that update to be in our routing database, we can modify that. So we can make it 255. So our router will say this is unreachable. So administrative distance is also a kind of filtering method. We have some others we can apply on outgoing interfaces. Distribute list, which is same here, and passive interface. Again, this passive interface does not advertise any routing updates, so we can filter out the update using this passive interface. So let's have a look at the topology and start configuring the topology and have a look at one by one these filtering methods. So I have this topology, RIP topology, where I have DMVP and tunnel here between router 2, 3 and 1. And first we configure here offset list. I have some routers, so let's see. Very basic requirement I would say for router 1, and I'm going to write here on router 1. Says router 1 says configure offset list and set metric value of 10 for routes coming from router 5. So router 5 is advertising some routes in routing updates. So whatever information coming from router 5, we don't want that information to be in database, or that should be in database of router 1, but that should have metric value of 10. So currently we have look at what information we have here. So I give command show IP route, and we can see the loopback of router 5 is 5.000/32, which has a metric value of 2. So whatever information coming from router 5, I want to keep the metric value of 10. So let's change this. So this we can change using offset list. So let's configure offset list, and we apply offset list in router 1. So when update comes in, so we need to see update is coming in or going out. So we are able to see here updates will come to router 1. So let's create access list 1, permit the host, which host you want to permit here. So host is 5.5.5.5, because router 5 is advertising this. Now I go to router rip mode, and I say offset list and the access list number, which access list means this access list 1 says 5, match 5. In means when update is coming in. 10, this is the metric value we can define. Now two things I am going to do here. I am going to clear the routing table, so it will take effect. Then I will see the route. So clear IP route star, and here I have given show IP route command, and let's see 5. So as we can see here, 5 is coming, but this time the metric value is 12, because 5 one hop, so 10 plus 1 11, and router 2 is also coming in middle of that. So you can see here 5 and 2 here, so 10 plus 2 12. So information is coming from router 5 that has now value 12, 10 plus 2, but rest information we can see all they have whatever is a default. So very simple and easy to configure offset list. Commands are very simple. So what we have configured, let's have a look. Show run section. We have applied this command offset list 1, which is access list number incoming, or you can set it for outgoing interface also, and 10. Let's see access list. So IP access list. So access list. As we can see, access list 5. That's it. So this is how offset list works. Now if I talk about second is distribute list. So distribute list will filter the updates coming in or going out of the interface. So our requirement, I can say I'm going to write my requirement. So based on the scenario, we can understand. This time I'm going to configure router 2. So here is the requirement. Router 2 wants to filter 172.16.34.0 network. Rest all networks should be reachable, and we have two options to match the network. So what are the two options we have here? We have access list and prefix list to perform this task. So distribute list requires these two, one of the option from these two. So I say router 2 wants to filter this network 16.34.0. let's see. So IP route, can we see this? Yes, the entry is available, but router 2 does not want this entry, but rest all entries should be there in RIP database. So what we can do is we are going to take and configure prefix list. So I would say I'm not going to take the configuration based on access list. We will take here prefix list to do this task. So it's very simple to do. So we need to create prefix list. The statement looks like this. I would say which network you want to deny, so you need to write that. So type the command IP prefix list deny 172.16.34.0 34.0. I'm giving the name. This is the entire name. Here deny is the option, and this is my network slash 24 you need to give, because here you can see this is slash 24, and enter. Now if I use this without giving an additional keyword or additional entry here, this is not going to work, because this is going to deny all other routes as well. So to permit all other routes, we need to create one more entry which will allow starting with zero prefix and ending with slash 32. So I say IP prefix list, same name, this time statement is permit, and 000 means everything, all subnet masks zeros starting with 0 and less than 32. That's it. So the name of prefix list is this. We are going to use this name along with distribute list. So again, I go to rip mode and I type the command here, router rip distribute list, and the name of distribute list here, the name already we have given, but the prefix list name. So I say distribute list prefix is the command, deny, this is the name, in, coming in. When this network comes to router 1, sorry, not for now, not to router 1, this router, this update comes to router 2, then only deny. It can come to router 1, it can go to router 3, but if this goes to router 2 via tunnel interface, via DMVPN, then only deny. If it is coming via any other interface, it will not deny. So I'm denying only via tunnel. Let's verify and clear the route and see the table. Do we have or we don't have? So clear IP route star and say show IP route and network ID. So as we can see, subnet not in table. But the same command, if I check and verify router 1, show IP route, this we can see we are learning. So router 1 is advertising it to router 2, but router 2 is saying I'm going to filter this out based on these two statements. So first statement is saying deny this particular network, permit everything else. So everything else means, can we see the loopback of router 4 or 41 network and any other networks? So we can verify. So as you see, other information is coming, the loopback of router 4 is coming, and you can ping as well. So this is how we can configure distribute list in our Cisco router. So we can apply distribute list when the packet comes in or when packet goes out. In both the cases we can apply. Now my third requirement, I would configure on router 3, and we can understand the distribute list where I will use along with ACL. Recently we have used prefix list and distribute list. I'm going to use now access list and distribute list. So my requirement says router 3 does not want to advertise 3.3.3.3 network. What we can use here, we can configure using ACL. So router 3 is advertising 3.3.3.3 is the loopback. Come to router 1 and router 2, we can see here on router 2, if you see 3.3.3 is coming. Router 1, if you see show IP route, we can see 3.3.3 is coming. So router 3 does not want to advertise. Then we can do this kind of ACL statement in router 3. And let's say configure. So access list, the number based access list I'm going to create, which is 3, deny host, particular host I want to deny means the particular IP address, and permit everything else. This is mandatory. If you don't give permit any, your route, all the information going from router 3 will be denied. So most important thing to be noticed here, need to give permit any. Now how do we want to apply this? Do you want to advertise, you don't want to advertise on fast ethernet 0 और सीरियल वन स्लैश जीरो और फास्ट थंडर 01। आई वुड से आई डोंट वॉन्ट टू एडवर्टाइज इट ऑन एनी इंटरफेस, सो फॉर दैट आई एम गोइंग टू यूज़ वेरी सिंपल थिंग, राउटर रिप एंड लेट्स से डिस्ट्रीब्यूट लिस्ट 3 एंड आउट। आउट आफ्टर आउट वी हैव सम स्टेटमेंट एंड ऑन विच इंटरफेस यू डोंट वॉन्ट टू एडवर्टाइज, यू डोंट वॉन्ट टू एडवर्टाइज ऑन सीरियल वन स्लैश जीरो और ऑन फास्ट थंडर 00। आई एम सेइंग आई डोंट वॉन्ट टू एडवर्टाइज इट एनी ऑन एनी इंटरफेस, सो दैट्स इट, लेट्स वेरीफाई नाउ ऑन राउटर वन वेदर वी आर लर्निंग और नॉट। सो राउटर वन सेज वी आर लर्निंग बट दिस टाइम यू सी द टाइमर वैल्यू इज एक्सीडिंग मोर देन 30 सेकेंड, सो राउटर वन इज नॉट एबल टू हियर नाउ दिस अपडेट। लेट्स क्लियर द टेबल, क्लियर आई पी डाउट स्टार, सो आई पी डाउट एंड आई वुड से 3333। सी देयर दिस नेटवर्क इज नॉट इन टेबल एंड इफ यू वॉन्ट टू सी ऑन राउटर 3 यू कैन वेरीफाई यूजिंग डीबग कमांड एज वेल, कैन सी डीबग आई पी रिप। सो राउटर 3 विल नॉट एडवर्टाइज 333 ऑन फास्ट ऑन एनी इंटरफेस, एज यू कैन सी सेंडिंग अपडेट बट 33 इज not being included as you can see here. Okay, so this is how we apply distribute list on incoming direction and outgoing direction. One more thing I'm going to talk about is administrative distance, and the task is the administrative distance I'm going to perform on router 1. And what is our task? Let's see. Router 1 wants all the networks learning from router 2 should have AD value of 100. So whatever information coming from router 2, all the networks coming from router 2, any route, that route should have AD value, administrative distance value of 100. Let's see what is the AD value coming from router 2. So IP route. 2222. So we can see the AD value distance is 120, and let's verify using this also. So IP route rip and see here 2 is coming, 5 is also coming, and see the AD value administrative distance value 120. We want to modify and we want to make it 100. So very simple command on router 1 we can give, which is distance command, and let's configure. So router rip distance 100, I'm going to give distance 100, and which is my source IP coming from, I can say router 2 or router 3. So whatever information is coming from this gateway or this neighbor, that those updates will have AD value of 100. Let's verify now. So IP route rip. This time we can see router 2. The loopback of router 2 is 222 with this value, and 5 is also coming from that here. Plus 25 is also coming from that here. 25 here. You see. This is the AD value 100. So this is how we can configure administrative distance as well in any device. Now another the filtering method is last is passive interface. So the task says passive interface will not allow any update going toward the neighbor which does not want. So router 1, 2 and 3 does not the spelling mistake. So router 3, 1, 2, 3, they do not want to advertise RIP updates where no RIP neighbors. So I can say router 1 says fast Ethernet 01 does not have any RIP neighbor. Router 3 says fast Ethernet 01 does not have. Router 2 also says fast Ethernet 0 does not have. So the command I'm going to give on all the routers, which is very simple command I would give. So on router 1 I would go and I will give command router rip passive interface and the name of interface where you don't want to advertise any update. Come to router 2, router rip passive interface fast ethernet 01. Router 3 also says router rip passive interface fast ethernet 01. We can verify using debug command. So I go to router 1 and I say am I advertising any update on fast ethernet 01? So debug IP rip. This will show us how are we advertising. So router 1 will advertise on fast ethernet 00 and will advertise it on loopback, but this will not advertise on fast ethernet 01. So we can see it's advertising on receive from tunnel, but here sending on tunnel, received and sending to loopback, but it's not sending to fast ethernet 01. This is how passive interface work. And let's verify passive interface. So IP protocols, and here we can see which interface is our passive interface, fast ethernet 01, and the AD value here we can see on router 1 which we have assigned for this neighbor is 100 and for router 3 is 120, and default for this device is 120. This is how all the filtering methods work here. We can learn more about any other features in coming series. So thank you for watching video on RIP, and we are gonna go ahead and do some more practicals on RIP. Bye bye.